This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Spindling, and this tutorial, Feathered. We are going to be plying feathers into our single. If you have a spinning wheel and you've taken the masterclass series from my wheel, I teach three different techniques of feathered. For spindling, I decided plying was the easiest and the most secure. So that's the one I recommend for drop spindle. So in order to complete this yarn, you will need a hand spun yarn, single. You'll need plying thread, something strong enough to not break or fall apart or the weight of your spindle to snap. And feathers. Our feathers have been provided by the beautiful Stacy Shipley of Lush Fiber Company on Etsy. They are chicken feathers from her backyard flock of very spoiled family farm chickens. Very spoiled. Quite possibly the most spoiled chickens I've ever seen on Facebook. So check out Lush Fiber Co. on Etsy and pick yourself up some chicken feathers. So I'm going to start by spinning a length just so that if I end up knitting or crocheting this, I have a nice easy cast on or bind off. Plus my leader thread is getting so short that like I can't even. I'm going to need new leader thread by this for the next one. One thing I'm noticing is like I'm winding my yarn on, but it's very loose. Do you like pull it tight as you wind it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I know I haven't been doing that at all.
It just fits more that way.
Yeah. Because I would notice mine would get like sloppy and like start falling down. Okay. So the first feather I'm going to add, cute little chicken feather with polka dots. How many things in nature have polka dots? Come on. So cute. Okay, I've only done this on a wheel, so bear with me. Let's figure out how to do this. I'm going to lay the feather parallel with the hand spun yarn. I'm going to twist the plying thread around the base of the feather for about an inch. I'm going to take the plying thread and place it behind the feather and pinch it with the hand spun yarn and continue plying so that the tip of the feather pops out.
Huh.
So the way this feather is secured is it is plied with the plying thread about halfway, and then the top of the feather is left free, and then the plying thread comes behind. When I move the plying thread behind, that's what allows this to pop free. Otherwise, the whole feather would be bound to the yarn.
Nice. That's gorgeous.
Isn't that fun?
That's so fun.
This is like one of my favorite techniques.
All right, so with the art yarn?
Yeah, hold it parallel to the yarn. And I like to have, like, feathers have a natural arch or bend with them, and I like to hold that arching downward rather than arching upward and pulling away from the yarn. Here, I'm going to show you close up. Okay. So I've got my thread right here. I'm pinching the feather, and I'm twisting that plying thread around the feather for about halfway. There it is. Now I'm going to pop the feather out of the yarn, take my plying thread, pinch it with the yarn, and twist behind, like that.
That's amazing.
I think that makes sense. Does that make sense
to
you?
So is this right?
Yes. This is sticking up and this is locked down.
All right.
Correct. just wait till your whole spindle is full. It's like, it's so
like creating a bird.
Adorable.
I'm gonna do a polka dot.
I love the polka dot ones. I love these ones too. These long, like skinny ones. For these really long, skinny ones, since they're so long, I don't really need to lock down half of the feather. Just locking down an inch of it should be adequate. So if you are looking at feathers for putting into yarn, I recommend really bendy, flexible, soft feathers. So not like seagull feathers or really hard quill type feathers, but get like a soft, moldable feather and just look at that.
Wow.
Not pretty.
Yay.
This is exciting. I love the polka dot ones. Like, I'm so in love with them.
You could have a hat with feathers on it.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes. This is also one of those yarns I don't set because I don't want the feathers to get smushed and matted and ugly looking. So this is a yarn that you need to treat with delicacy. Probably wouldn't do well as socks. But it'd be great as a cowl.
Yes.
Okay, what am I going to do next? I'm going to do this little red feather, like a peach feather. I love these feathers. Start a game. Every time Ashley says, I love these feathers, take a drink of coffee or whatever. It's the spindling drinking game. Seltzer.
Wow.
Ooh.
Now how, like, okay, yeah. See, that's plenty bendy, but the very end of this is quilly, so I would nip off, like, 1 centimeter so that it doesn't, like, poke.
Okay.
Like, cut off.
So do we have scissors?
Yeah. Cut off, like, the bottom most centimeter of that. Yes.
Ish.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that way it won't, like,
yeah.
It'll just kind of like meld with your yarn better.
This makes me feel exotic.
That's another t-shirt. This makes me feel exotic. I'm gonna do this one.
It's giving sheep their wings. There you go.
When sheep fly. It's the barnyard bonanza. So we've got chicken, sheep. We could get some alpaca. We've got to have like cowhide or something in there. The Barnyard Bonanza. Ta-da.
That's gorgeous.
I also like to have all my feathers going in the same direction, and usually as I'm spinning, I like them to point upward rather than pointing downward into my yarn. I just find that it makes them not get as damaged as I'm spinning. And I'll show you another, like, not cheat, but tip for if you're finding your feathers aren't securing well into your yarn. Mine are locked in, but I've also been doing this a bit this month. So you should be able to hold your spindle up by your feather. I'm going to call that secure. Oh, I love that.
That's pretty.
So another trick of the trade, if you're finding your feathers are rebelling against you, is I'm going to do the striped one.
That's nice.
Take your plying thread, create a slip knot, stick the feather in the slip knot, and pull it tight. This thread isn't going to work with that though, because it's too rough. But that will actually tie a really secure knot around your thread, and your feather will be a little more secure.
Will the end stick out?
You would still wrap the end in, but it would just have one more knot, one more extra security measure. So that it's not like you're tying a knot and then plying. You're tying a knot and then securing it, and it's just for extra stability. I love that one. Cute. Yes, that's secure. If it can hold up your spindle, and I've got 4 weights on mine, like that's a lot of weight for these feathers to be holding up.
So I'll trim this one down probably too.
Oh, it's that one's probably from a rooster.
I bet you're right.
I want one of those long ones. Yeah, this one. I love
these.
Those are gorgeous. I love these. If you're in the market for feathers and chicken feathers aren't your thing, you can also try peacock feathers and emu feathers and boa feathers. You can do like chunks of boa.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's almost like that fun fur yarn.
Yes,
at the bottom.
Yes. It reminds me of lashed a little bit too.
Yes.
Are you finding yours are secure enough?
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Yeah, they are.
Good. Cool. I think I'm just going to add one more.
All right.
And I'll be done.
This one has a stripe.
This is one of those addicting yarns that I feel like I could spin all day.
Yes.
Like whenever I was doing this for my spindling class, I didn't want to stop. Not spindling. When I was spinning this for my wheel class. It's like a book that you don't want to end.
Yes.
Okay, my last feather is going to be, I'm going to do a brown one. Do you have the scissors?
Yes.
The very, like half inch to a centimeter of the base of this feather is just a tiny bit quilly. So in order to make it adhere to the yarn better, I'm just going to nip that off.
Okay. Feathered.
Feathered.
It's kind of amazing.
It's really cute. Okay. Done. So when you're done, cut your thread and your yarn, tie it in a knot so it doesn't untwist. Do you need me to cut something
for you? I'm good.
Or you're back? Wow.
Yep.
We'll do show and tell.
Show and tell.
Here's mine.
Love it.
Super cute.
Oh, that's cool.
So cute.
Yay! Cool.
Very, very cute. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you for watching and happy spindling.